picked the wrong week to quit sniffing glue.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back. It is week two, second week on this second contact, and we're working on the saucer this week. I have to say, I've been delighted by the comments made from the first week. I never thought there would be such keen interest in my cast-offs. I have, at last count, like five people all vying for the old hull. I don't know what to do exactly. I'm thinking of maybe a death match, maybe a Thunderdome type of thing. Maybe, you know, five men enter, one man leaves. I don't know exactly what's going to happen with the old hull. I had joked at one point of hanging onto it and gold plating it and putting it on the wall like Picard had in his ready room. But I just don't know, because I don't know if I'm done with it, because there may be some parts I need to take off of it. It could happen. At least I want to show you, as I progress into the painting of this, I want to show you what I did on the old one and contrast that with how I'm going to do it on the new one. But this week we are working on the last bit of major construction, and that is making sure that the inside of the bottom of the saucer, or the bottom of the saucer, fits the top of the saucer. And the way that that has to fit is it actually sits inside the rim. The rim of this is very thin, and it requires you to carefully sand and or file and or scrape away the outside edge of this and the channel along the inside so that this sits down in it. And then once I've got that far, I could figure out whether or not I'm going to be able to light the maneuvering thrusters and or even get lights out to the windows that are on this edge here. Have to be very careful because there's a nice bit of detail. Also, there are nav lights, navs and strobes. Now, I was watching First Contact again, and I have to tell you, at the top of the show today, the paint scheme for this may not be as dark as the Nemesis paint scheme, but it's not going to be as light as the First Contact paint scheme. First Contact paint scheme had a lot of the same, and that was, I think, First Contact was the last time, Chummy, check me on this if I'm wrong, I think that was the last movie that was used a physical model for. I think they switched over to the CG model for Nemesis and for Insurrection, but I'm not sure. But the physical model, the paint schemes were a lot lighter. It was a lot less contrasty. And I don't know that I like that. I like the idea of the Nemesis / Insurrection paint scheme, but maybe not as dark gray. So we're going to see. We're going to see how that shakes out. That's a while. That's a ways off yet. But I was watching First Contact, and it struck me that the navs and strobes, which have always been a bit of a sticking point. Do the red and yellow, or do the red and green lights blink, or do they not? And I know it goes back to classic original Enterprise TV series that you had these blinking, and they were white on the bottom and they were red and green on the top. But there were multiple lights there. And those, you know, most notably those blinked. But when you get further down the line, the Enterprise D, for example, red and green lights on that did not blink, because there were lights here, there were lights back on the secondary hull, and if they're marker lights, they really shouldn't blink. And from what I can gather on the Enterprise on First Contact, the red and green lights were on constantly, but there was a blinking white light like next to it. So I'm going to do some further research on that. I don't think there's going to be room all the way out here on the edge. And I will show you. All the way out here on the edge, that's where the tiny light goes. And by the time you sandwich this bottom piece into that, there just may not be room to run anything. I used an oversized 1 mil bulb on the first build, and maybe that was too big. And then I'm remembering the horrible thing that happened with the Enterprise D that I made, where that light spill, because it was a clear kit just like this, that the red and red and green light spill, it encompassed all of these other windows, which is no bueno either. So I'm thinking what I may end up doing is put a constant on light here that is white, tinting it so that it tinting from the outside so that I don't have that problem, and then maybe putting a flasher or a strobe next to it. I don't want to go strobe heavy on this thing. There is a white light here. There is a strobe behind the bridge. And then there's a belly strobe. And then there are strobes on the back of the nacelles way at the end. I think those are the only ones I'm going to have strobing, are the bridge, the belly, and the engines. I'll have to check. I'll have to see on all of that, because I think you can go two nuts with strobe lights. This is, you know, I don't want to induce any sort of seizures from this thing. But I'm looking at this kit and I am admiring the fact that this is a very stable front end, a top end here. On my original kit, I recall this being concave, like it had deformed in the mold or something. This looks nicely reinforced. I got this from Simon, as I said, but for some reason it looks like it had been, somebody tried painting something on or hitting this with a little bit of paint, and I don't like that. So if I can't clean that off, actually I can't, because it looks like it is in the fiberglass itself, like dirty fiberglass. Hopefully the light shining through that for the windows won't be too marred by that. So today is a lot of tedious sanding and filing as I try to get this inside edge pared down to let the bottom half rest in it. So this is Thanksgiving week, so I will be giving thanks if I can get this bit of construction done. Join me, won't you? Hey, I'm continuing work on the saucer here, and I am remembering the sheer blinding tedium that is making these two parts fit. Although I have to say, it's going easier this time than the first time, and I think it's because I've got better tools. I don't know. But we're basically, I'm working this joint all the way around, and I'm remembering how fragile this outer edge is. One captured air bubble, and that's all that stands between you and the inky void of space. So trying to be very careful to get everything to fit here and not to tear out this side wall here. I'm happy with how everything is fitting pretty much up to the center, and it's taken all morning to get there. So I'm going to take a bit of a break, count my blessings, count my fingers, count my toes, and come back to it a little bit later and try to do the other side. Good morning, everybody. Welcome back. It's Tuesday. We're going to pick up where we left off yesterday on the bottom of the top of the saucer, if that makes any sense to you. Also, the top of the bottom of the saucer. When last you left me, I had completely done the starboard side. Yes, it's upside down and backwards. This is the starboard side. And got that all nice and sanded in and grinded and buffed and all of that. And then two things happened that stopped me in my tracks, literally. I was starting to work on this side and I hit a big old bubble. Just a big old bad casting bubble right down through here. And I realized that if I tried chipping away any more of that, I was going to lose great sections of the hull. So what I did is I stopped and reinforced the area of that bubble with epoxy sculpt. Now epoxy sculpt has to, you know, to really set up, it has to set up overnight. So I took the opportunity to pack this area, plus a couple of other smaller bits where I had some bubbles show up. And I packed those with epoxy sculpt, and I let them sit overnight so that they could be nice and strong. Because when I want to go in today and finish grinding that out, I wanted to be a solid foundation behind it. And there were some places where I actually overpacked it, knowing that I could come back and sand it down. But that was the first thing. And the second thing is I had my method yesterday was to grind a little bit, you know, and of course you're throwing dust up in the air, so you want to be careful with that. So I had my mask on and all of that, but I'm grinding, and it's causing dust. So every so often I pull out this little portable vacuum cleaner that I have. It's one of those small battery operated things that you can use in your car or whatnot. It's got a charger on it, and so I was using that to suck up the dust every once in a while, just so it would stay in control. And I had it sitting on a chair, and I was, you know, pulling the hose out and doing the cleanup. And the hose pulled it too far. It came off the chair and landed on my longest toe, not my big toe, the second toe, the one that sticks out the farthest. And at least on me, I'm a hideous mutant. I don't know about you. The long toe caught the brunt of that, and it had the exact same effect as if you had, I don't know, kicked the leg of a coffee table or something in the dark and really just creamed that toe. So, I'm not an overly sensitive man, but that brought words to my mouth that perhaps were not best shared with others. And literally took me off of my foot for the rest of the day, because that thing hurt, and it still hurts today. So I'm walking around gingerly on it. But that kind of just put me in a foul mood for working on it for the rest of the day. So I just gave up for the rest of the day. Also, I'm starting to gather in my supplies for the building and the lighting of this beast. Some of my LEDs came in yesterday. I've placed orders out to different vendors. But what I want to use particularly for the strobes this time around are these, let me take the battery off of it so you can see. These, what they call lighthouse LEDs that have a tip to them. This way I can actually use this to poke up through the hull to be the strobe, or if in a pinch I can attach more easily attach a fiber optic to the end of it and then send the fiber where it needs to go. But I've got room for these, particularly in the nacelles, in the back of the nacelles, so I figured I would use these this time. And we have an issue like this strobe that goes back here behind the bridge. Well, let's get it in camera. There's a strobe that goes right about, let's see if I get the pencil out. There's a strobe that goes right about here, right behind the bridge, and as thick as the resin, fiberglass resin piece is here, I think that probably the best result will be to sand that down a bit from the inside and then use these lighthouse style LEDs to do that delicate work. So let's get back to the sanding. I have found it works very well if I take a little bit off of the bottom and a little bit off of the top at the same time, and not too much off of either one. Here's a mistake that I don't know who did it and where it came from. Here's the thing. I don't know if it was cast this way and cleaned up, or maybe even Simon did it. I don't know. This area here is cleaned out. That's a mistake. That area here should be less solid. The reason why is because you've got to attach the secondary hull there, and the secondary hull actually sits inside. It sits inside of this shape. This lip that's been left here isn't wide enough. So I either need to sand it the rest of the way off and create a new lip. I think that's going to be the best way around it, the best way around that problem. Yeah, I think the best thing to do is going to be to sand this off solid and then replace it with a solid piece here. And then cut out access holes where I need to rather than having this whole thing wide open. Okay, after another session of vigorous sanding and grinding and foot protection, you can still see how much dust I've got on me here, which is not good to be kicking this back up in the air, but I need to do another vigorous cleaning. The bottom is now in and secure to the top. Now, we're a long way in from ever gluing this down because I still have to do all of the work inside, but we've got a nice level meeting here, and you can still see where I've got some huge bubble gaps there that really can't do anything with at this point, because if I do, it'll seal the top and bottom together, so I just have to treat those very carefully for right now. And let me see, I think I might need to push one last little bit of grinding here to push that down a little bit further. Okay, it's taken a couple of days and a fairly hefty amount of sanding, but I think I've got a top and bottom here joined sufficiently and nice and clean and nice and level. And now I think the next step is, this is not going to be gluing, but I just want to show you what the thing starts to look like when you add all the other parts to it. And here you can see the problem I'm running into. This is almost sinking down inside there. That's why I'm going to have to reinforce that neck hole in the top of the saucer. But you can see it's starting to, you can see where I've puttied up some stuff here that I've been playing with that seam. But you can really start to see the length of the thing. The next step I want to do is go ahead and reinforce that inner hole with something. Might even just be straps across it. I'm going to need something to give me some more glue surface, particularly when we get back here. You can already see the big gap there. Alrighty, I just cut a piece of sheet stock styrene. Say that 5 times real fast without your coffee in the morning. Sheet stock styrene, sheet stock styrene, sheet stock styrene. Just to fill in this area, you can see by the original piece that it was filled in. It was part of the resin, and I only ended up cutting out parts only because I wanted to stick a transformer here and a wire chase here. So I don't anticipate needing to cut too many more holes in it than that for this second half. Although it might give me a place to run the armature up through. I'm probably going to have to cut a half moon in the back to make room for that. That certainly wasn't something that was on my mind the first time. So better to have the extra stuff be in here for reinforcement than to not have it. And as I said, I need it to sit this thin. I put a fairly thin piece in here so as not to bump this up too much. It still sits very nice without coming way out here. It's a difference that makes very little difference. So happy with how those two things look. And with it being white, it'll actually help reflect light. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make that rhyme, but I did it anyway. Now I'm just going to epoxy that in, or maybe a CA or epoxy. Probably epoxy. That way it'll goosh out into all the corners. Okay, hopefully you can see from the top side now this piece that I have put in. And I've laid it out, and I'm looking how it lays on the hull and all, or the secondary hull and all that. And I can already tell that I have a feeling I'm going to have to cut out an area like about there to run a bunch of stuff. So let's do that with a simple pair of scissors. And we can get on with, I feel like I need to reinforce that area right down in here, but that's going to bump up to where the impulse engine is, and I'm not quite sure the best way to handle that. Again, it was solid in the original piece. Okay, snip that bit out so I've got access. I'm thinking that I may end up using this as my landing zone for whatever I end up putting here as far as my armature. So I'm thinking that it's going to end up being reinforced with fiberglass anyway. So we're just going to have to start seeing how this stuff starts shaking out. Now, you know, there's a school of thought that says, hey, why don't you go ahead and glue this down to the secondary hull while you've got it. But there's a ton of work that needs to be done on the inside here. I need to have lighting in here. I need to have something, obviously a light for the deflector dish. There are windows that need to be lit on the outside. So there's no way that I'm ready to close that area off. But one thing I think I can do today is to go ahead and put the bottom pans of the nacelles. Maybe I could put those on here, and that will give you the complete idea of the length. I just need to make sure I've cut big enough holes in those bottom pans for all of this wiring to come up through.
Hey gang, it's Lou. Pardon the interruption, but I need to jump in here to say that something happened and I lost an entire day's worth of video. Right at this juncture, I lost it. I didn't notice that till I started pulling everything in on Friday here to pull the video together, and I realized it wasn't there. In that video, three important things happened that you probably need to see. And here's one. One is that I fiberglassed in this bit of copper pipe. And this bit of copper pipe into the white piece that you saw me make, and then all of a sudden it jumps, and this is done, and you need to know why. This was a day's worth of fiberglassing, and then letting it cure overnight and coming back to it the next day. The second part of this is what was actually accomplished before that was that I got the big torch out again, and I welded stuff, and I managed to do it without turning the house on fire, without losing any eyebrows, without burning myself. I think it went very well, but I managed to take all of these parts and put them together and do the soldering on it, and it came out just fine. I found out that I had been a little bit too clever for my own good, which is not the first time that's happened, won't be the last. I was thinking that the copper pipe that I had got before, that was a half inch outer diameter, was actually a half inch inner diameter, and it was too big. So I went one size down, got the 3/8 copper pipe, and that is exactly a half inch outer diameter. So I was able to use that and substitute the 3/8 inch pipe for the half inch that I got the day before. So all's well and good on that. And the last thing I did that you probably should know about is that I put these inserts in to the tops of the nacelle pieces. And that I just splayed them out. They had nice little notches in them to help them sit. I just needed to, you know, hold them in place, put the CA in it. And then after it had cured, I went back in and I reinforced that with clear epoxy all the way around it, so that these are now in place, and that makes this a much more stable piece to work with. And then later in the video you'll see me put the fronts on. But that's the quick catch up on it. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened. I didn't check the video until I went to throw everything in and saw that I had lost the whole day. So that's it. That's the story. We now return you to your normally scheduled program already in progress.
All right, well, I've just spent the last hour or so working with the JB Weld, working it into the joints here. Nice thing about JB Weld is it takes a while to cure, but while it's doing that, it smooths itself out. It finds its own level. And that's going to be handy when it comes to sinking down into a crack or feathering itself out to the edge of something or finding its own level. So what I've done on the bottom sides here of these nacelle bottoms and the main seam here, just go ahead and dress that up a little bit, and filling in what you cannot see here on camera, filling in the low side of the deflector trench. There was a low side and a high side where it didn't quite meet up. So letting the low side fill in, and I may come back in and dress that up again after that first coat has set up. So that's a good spot to leave it for while I go check out the lunch options. Alrighty, I'm continuing to work on the details of this center line here. I've included this rear photon launcher, just a little resin add-on piece, and these two launchers up front that I actually cut off of my old kit to put in place there, because the ones that are cast on the new parts, I only found one of them and it wasn't done all that well. So I just go ahead and pull off the other two. And I'm looking at something, and it strikes me at on the deflector dish, I had cleaned this area out so that it would have the light shine behind it. And I pull out my old kit and I notice that I drilled that out, and I put a piece of clear frosted in behind it. Here's the piece of clear frosted that I put in behind it. But I actually drilled, let me see, get the camera up here. There you go. I actually drilled that out in the old kit, so I'm wondering if that doesn't make sense to go ahead and do that on this one as well. Oh, look at this old sad thing. Well, I'm looking at the windows that are here, because that is the next step, is going to be putting masks over all the windows in the secondary hull so that I can put a primer coat over this, and that'll also show me whatever seams need to be cleaned up. But I can't risk running the risk of putting the primer over top of any of these window holes. So I'm going to use this as a reminder, because some of the windows in here are not that easy to see, but this will help me remember where they are and how they're located and all of that stuff. Also, I get a chance to correct a mistake I made here, and that was these areas where these lifeboats go on the secondary hull. I did not mask that off correctly before I painted the darker gray, so I have to remind myself that there are lifeboat decals that go there, and I should at least pencil that off so that I know not to paint that dark gray. But yeah, without the risk of going all full Barbra Streisand, this is bringing back the memories. Misty watercolor memories of the starship that we were. So we'll let this sit. This is where I have a tendency to work on wet materials, and I end up regretting it. So I'm just going to let this sit. Okay, one last bit I can do today, and I'm starting to already think about the last thing I can do today, because this really does need to cure for a while. But one last thing I can do on this belly today is install this phaser strip. Now, it's meant to go here, and that's a pretty tight curve, but it's cast flat, and I'm going to have to soak this in really hot water to get it to the point where it will bend over the curve that I need it to have. So I would have wished for something like that to have been molded a little bit better, molded up with the curve already in it. Okay, that part is down. Now, I wish I had the camera running, but if I thought it was going to be that quick, I would have. But it was so rubbery when it came out of the hot water that I needed to hurry up and quick put it down before it deformed all out of shape. But there you go. And again, this is something you'll see better once the primer coat is on. Got a kind of some squared off edges here that need to be rounded over. But I can do that once. That helps it show up a little bit better. But once the all of this JB weld has cured, that'll be easier to tell. I pretty much had one shot to get it, the center of it down in the right place, and the made sure both end caps ended where they were supposed to, and when it went down, it didn't distort this way. Getting it to bend completely over the hull this way was one trick, but making sure it didn't also bend this way was the other. So that's going to take a little bit of sanding and filing, but that's good. Mail call came today while the camera was off also, and I am literally swimming in HD strip lighting from Paragraphics, so yay, we can progress on to next week's work with reckless abandon, knowing that I've got all of the strip lighting I will probably ever need.
Yeah, this is the point in the week where I always go around saying, well, one more thing, well, one more thing. Well, I think this is one more thing I can get done today, get done for the week before we set it all, you know, set it aside for the weekend and then come back to it next week. And I think I'm going to go ahead and attach the front of the nacelles or the Bassard collectors into the front of the nacelles. I can still work with it. I'm used to working with this all being one piece anyway from the first time that I did this, but I can go ahead and work with this and get it in there and then get it reinforced from the inside with epoxy and still be able to put it all down on top of the bottom of the nacelle without having to doing a bunch of stressing and fighting. So it's going to be easier for me to make this match the contours of the top now than it would be if I put it on and I had to fight it while it was attached to the top of the ship. So what I have to do is spread these out a little bit so that they better fit the contours of this piece and then tack that down and let it hold it open. Actually, what I think I'd like to do is if I could cut a couple pieces of short pieces of wood, just a little bit of dowel rod, and just stick it in there to kind of splay those open a little bit. That will help hold them in the right position. That'll be right back. Hey, that's a good spot to leave it for the weekend. This JB weld does take, I won't say about twice as long, but it takes a goodly amount longer to set up than regular epoxy does. But once it does, it's really well worth it. It's an excellent light block. But it also, like I said, it will self-level because it takes so long to cure that it will actually kind of pond itself out and seek its own level before it, in the time that it takes for it to set up. So it's great for pushing down into joints that you want a light block. It's excellent for that. I'm using it in this instance to join up the area of the clear resin and the opaque resin. It makes an excellent light block in that joint. And as we all know, the problems you can have with a piece of clear is that it wants to light leak everywhere around the edges. So I've got a little bead on the inside and I've got a bead on the outside, and that's smeared down and drying. Oh, I didn't put the bead on this. Well, actually, I put clear epoxy on the inside of this one. So I may want to go over that again with the JB weld. We'll have to see. I think I had some clear resin left over and I just went ahead and put it inside there. So good. We'll let that rest and we'll pick this up again on Monday. Okay, because I like doing this on Friday afternoon, I've basically pieced everything together. I've laid the saucer on top and I've laid the top of the nacelles on top, but here we get a preliminary look at how this ship is going to fit on this stand. And it is,
It is unusual seeing those nacelles sitting as squarely as they do. Now, like I said, these are just sitting on top here, so they've not been squared up. But you can get a really... see, this is camera distortion. When I do this, the nacelles look closer together. When I do this, they look farther apart. So that's distortion of the camera. And you can see clearly that the top of the saucer is not joined at the neck there. But this will give you probably the best indication to date of what this ship is going to look like once it is all back together, or together for the first time. This one wasn't back together. This one was together for the first time. So nothing, no lights to show, none of that yet. But we've come a long, long way in just this short week. There's the armature with the post attached. Now everything's going to rest up and heal and cure until next Monday. And with that, we come to the end of the second week on the Enterprise E. A shortened week, a truncated week, a week that had a holiday smack in the middle of it. So no work done on it yesterday. I hope you all had a fine Thanksgiving, that your family arguments were few, and that the food was plentiful. Until next week, when we will pick up this, I'll pick this up right now, we'll pick this up, and we will start doing the wiring on it because of the wonderful things he does. Yes, Wizard of Oz was on last night. Because I need to start working in this area before I can attach the saucer. I need to start working in this whole area. So this is what I would consider the groundwork. A lot of the groundwork is done now. And now we're going to get into phase two, which is the putting the guts in it, the wiring and the lighting. And to do that, as I've said, we're going to have to start priming some parts, which means putting tedious window masks on. So I'm already dreading that. Next week, we will be on week three of this Enterprise E, and we will be carrying it along. As we get into the holiday season, of course, you know you need to take time with your families, your in-laws, your outlaws, and the demon shopping, which I'm going to try to do in as few trips as possible this year. So, until next week, be good. Be good to each other. Be safe. Be smart. We will see you here next time.